Arirang Special.
Maurizio Pollini of Italy. Christian Zimmerman of Poland. Marta Arharic of Argentina. These people are world-renowned pianists. They have one more thing in common. They are the winners of the International Friedrich Chopin Piano Competition. And in October 2015, in Warsaw, the capital of Poland and the hometown of Friedrich Chopin, another great pianist made his name as the whole world looked on with excitement. We begin the story of the International Friedrich Chopin Piano Competition 2015. Warsaw is located in central Poland. Anyone who visits Warsaw begins their journey back in time in this square. The historic center of Warsaw was created in the 13th century. Up until the 18th century, a market opened near the square, and festivals were held here frequently. It still bears the traces of the medieval period. In 1980, the historic center of Warsaw was added to the list of the UNESCO World Heritage. This millennium-old place is always full of musicians singing about their era. The artists' performances entertain tourists visiting Poland. Nowadays, the historic center of Warsaw is a place of rest to the public. But up until 50 years ago, the majority of the city did not exist. This place used to be a venue of numerous revolutions and wars. During World War II, Warsaw was turned into the most horrendous city in the world. About 85% of the city was destroyed by the Nazis. For about two decades after the war, Polish people did their best to restore their medieval city by collecting every single brick and stone that was left on the streets after the destruction. Their strong will to restore the city wrote a new chapter in history. St. Anne's Church was built in 1454. It has been preserved despite numerous destructions and extensions. Beautiful icons and sculptures make the golden altar even more extravagant. Warsaw is also home to a palace that has survived a tumultuous period and even World War II. It's the Wilanowski Palace. It represents the 17th century Baroque style. It's one of the most marvelous structures in Poland. It was modeled after the Palace of Versailles of France. Outside the old section of the city, in the new town of Warsaw, which is full of stores, you will encounter the most prominent musician of Poland. The otherwise ordinary-looking stores are full of the images of this musician. He's none other than Friedrich Chopin, the poet of the piano. In Poland, Chopin is a very special figure. You cannot talk about Warsaw without mentioning Chopin. In other words, Chopin is the soul of Poland and the spirit of the Polish nation.
Chopin, no to jest częścią naszej kultury, ale częścią kultury światowej również. Jest bardzo polski, ale uniwersalny. Bardzo lubię jego muzykę.
Najpiękniejsza muzyka świata, najwspanialsza polska muzyka. Aha. Cieszymy się, że jest znana na całym świecie. Aha. Bardzo jesteśmy z tego dumni.
Warsaw is a city where modernity coexists with traditions and music. Chopin's presence can be felt even on benches where people sit down to rest. At a glance, this looks like a chair commemorating Chopin. The moment you touch it, a beautiful melody starts playing. In Warsaw, Chopin's music is a part of daily life. After a one-hour ride from Warsaw, we arrive at Czelejowa Wola, the hometown of Fryderyk Chopin. The house where Chopin was born is located in the middle of a park, where lush trees planted by Chopin's fans from all over the world grow. Born in March 1810, Chopin lived in this house until he moved to Warsaw at age 7. Now, it's a museum. In the house, you can see the portraits of Chopin's family, portraits of Chopin himself, sheet music, and a piano that he used.
Tutaj trzeba podkreślić w Żelazowej Woli to jest to, że od wielu dziesiątków już lat organizowane są koncerty chopinowskie. W każdą letnią niedzielę mamy koncerty dla słuchaczy zgromadzonych w parku. To jest też taka specyficzna formuła takich koncertów, ponieważ pianista gra wewnątrz domu, a turyści, słuchacze siedzą w parku przez otwarte drzwi, okna, muzyka. Również przez mikrofon przekazywana jest do parku i ta niepowtarzalna atmosfera koncertów stwarza, że tak wiele tysięcy ludzi to miejsce odwiedza corocznie.
In 1831, when Chopin lived in Paris, he heard about Warsaw's surrender to Russia. To express his despair and pain, he wrote a composition entitled Revolutionary Etude. Music is vibrant and fierce. This piece of music clearly conveys Chopin's sorrow. Although Chopin lived away from his home country, he never stopped loving and missing it. This composer was born to play the piano, and he dedicated all his life to it. Chopin mostly performed and wrote music in Paris, but his music style was clearly Polish. He expressed the love for his home country in his polonaises, mazurkas, and uniquely extravagant and lyrical etudes. His music was like poetry. Although Chopin never had a chance to go back to his home country, he wanted his heart to be buried in Poland. According to his wish, his heart was buried in Warsaw 19 years later. Chopin wanted Mozart's Requiem to be played at his funeral. Even after two centuries, concerts in memory of Fryderyk Chopin are held all over Poland to this day. Every 5 years, Poland hosts the International Chopin Piano Competition.
No, jest to bardzo specjalny kompozytor, nie tylko dla Polaków, ale dla wszystkich na całym świecie. I to jest fascynujące, specjalnie co 5 lat konkurs, który sprowadza wszystkich z całego świata i wszyscy Chopina grają. Każdy go troszkę w inny sposób czuje, ale każdy człowiek jest w środku inny.
Three days before the International Friedrich Chopin Piano Competition 2015, the contestants gathered in one place. This time, the competition drew 450 contestants. Among them, 78 contestants from 19 countries advanced to the main competition. Today, they are drawing their performing order. Eight Korean contestants made it to the main competition. They include such promising names as Cho Sung-jin, Han Chi-ho, Kim Soo-yeon, and An Soo-jung.
Piano 부문의 세계 최고의 콩쿠르라고 할 수 있고요. 올해는 한국 연주자들이 8명이 그 본선에 진출을 하게 되었습니다. 그래서 2005년에 임동혁, 임동민 형제들이 공동 3위를 해서 좋은 소식을 전해줬는데요. 올해도 파이널 무대에서 아마 더 좋은 소식이 있지 않을까 기대해봅니다.
쇼팽은 워낙 모든 사람들이 좋아하는 곡이지만 저도 또 굉장히 좋아해서 이제 쇼팽 곡을 많이 칠 수 있는 이 콩쿠르에 참가하게 됐고요. 너무 온 것만으로도 영광이고 어쨌든 지금 막 순서 추첨해서 조금 이제 막 시작을 조금이나마 실감하게 돼서 좀 떨리네요. 네.
쇼팽 콩쿠르에 참가하게 돼서 정말 영광스럽게 생각하고 저 첫 번째 날에 걸렸는데 이제 조금 콩쿠르가 시작됐다는 걸 실감하게 됐어요.
준비는 얼마나 하셨어요?
뭐 그냥 쇼팽 곡은 제가 어렸을 때부터 늘 하던 레퍼토리여서 콩쿠르 위해 뭐 특별히 쇼팽만 준비하고 이런 건 아니고 그냥 제가 어렸을 때부터 준비해오던 거라서 네 그냥
The contestants have only played Chopin's compositions and thought only about Chopin in order to win the competition. Who of the 78 pianists will win the grand prize? Launched in 1927, the Chopin Competition is a prestigious piano competition that has been held once in every 5 years for 88 years, except during World War II. Numerous talented pianists made their names at the Chopin competition, writing a new chapter in the history of classical music.
There was also a competition when Dmitri Shostakovich took part in as a pianist here in Warsaw, yes. And he got honorable mention. He didn't win, but he took part in the Chopin competition.
When was that?
It was in 1927, so at the first competition.
There was a notable scandal, too. The first prize winner of the fifth Chopin competition was Adam Harasiewicz of Poland. The second prize winner was Vladimir Ashkenazy of Russia. Furious by the outcome, jury member Arturo Benedetti Michelangeli threatened to resign. Nonetheless, the Chopin competition is undoubtedly a birthplace of the world's classical music stars. Maurizio Pollini, the best pianist of our time. Marta Argerich, who mesmerizes audiences with her perfect and energetic performances. Chris Christian Zimmermann, a Polish genius pianist who was the youngest to be awarded the first prize along with many other special awards in the history of the Chopin competition. These prominent pianists became superstars during the 88-year history of the competition. Some of the great masters participated in the Chopin competition 2015 as jury members.
Zaprosiliśmy do jury rekordową liczbę laureatów i zwycięzców konkursu chopinowskiego z historii. Zatem tym razem ten regulamin jest nieco prostszy. Więcej zależy od samego głosowania niż od wyliczeń komputerowych. Chodziło o to, żeby regulamin był nieco bardziej, można powiedzieć, humanistyczny, a mniej technologiczny.
In 2015, the competition rules were changed. Contestants were evaluated on a scale of 1 to 25 instead of the previous scale of 1 to 100 to prevent irregularities. Those who manage to pass the strict criteria and captivate the hearts of the music masters will see their lives changed by 180 degrees.
Of course, they got prizes. It's obvious that they should enter the most important concert halls in Europe and all over the world. So we plan a kind of the tournée for prize winners, including concerts in such concert halls like Concerthebouw in Amsterdam. They will also travel to Japan and China to play their recitals and also concert with great orchestras. So that's our offer.
The winner also receives support from the record industry. This competition, Universal Music decided to produce the winner's album even before the results were out.
I have always wanted to work with this marvelous competition and to arrange for the winner to come out on the Deutsche Grammophon label. This is the first time that one of our labels, and in particular Deutsche Grammophon, agrees to take the winner of a competition without knowing who it's going to be. And I'm very happy we're doing it.
Before all the participants come up on stage at the opening ceremony of the competition, there is one more thing they must do: choose the right piano for themselves. They must play the piano they choose in the three rounds and even in the final round of the competition to show off their skills. It's a challenging journey where only one of the 78 contenders will be the winner. The great journey now begins. On October 3rd, the first round of the 15th Chopin competition took place. It drew a large crowd of discerning spectators who came to see how the young artists will perform Chopin's various piano compositions.
Etude도 쳐야 되고 녹턴도 쳐야 되고 마즈루카도 쳐야 되고 월츠, 스케르초, 발라드, 판타지 뭐 너무 많은 그 쇼팽의 이 곡을 연주를 해야 되는데 마즈루카는 고국에 돌아가지를 못하는데 고국에 돌아가고 싶어서 고국을 생각하면서 고국을 그리면서 쓴 그런 감정이거든요. 그러니까 그런 것에 어느 정도 근접해서 비슷하게라도 아 이런 내용의 것을 이런 감정을 표현을 하고 싶었거나 이런 것은 알 수 있을 것 같아요. 그래서 그것에 대한 어떤 정리가 굉장히 중요할 것 같습니다.
To receive recognition, the contestants must express Chopin's music with their bodies and souls. After long preparation, the young artists can't help but feel nervous as they start the first round. In the first round, they must perform two etudes in a row in any order they want. Performing Chopin's nocturnes is a huge pressure for contestants because they require innocent emotions and subtle sentimentality rather than good performing techniques.
Maybe the beginning, because entering in such a big hall is quite scary, and you have to be comfortable since the first note. So. I hope it arrived.
The competition was fierce right from the start. Round one was held for 5 days. Cho Sung-jin from Korea performed on the first day. Since when he was a child, Cho Sung-jin has been fond of Chopin's Fantaisie. The great composer wrote it when his talent reached its peak. Kim Hong-gi is a medalist of the Maria Canals International Music Competition held in Barcelona, Spain. Ka Ju-yeon is the winner of the 2014 Troisdorf International Piano Competition held in Germany. These Korean contestants have performed with famed orchestras, but they are as nervous as everyone else to compete in the first round of the Chopin competition. It takes talent and courage to win this competition. Among the Korean contenders, Cho Sung-jin, Han Chi-ho, An Soo-jung, Kim Soo-yeon, and Park Jin-hyung advanced to the second round.
I think that among the all Asians, Chinese, Chinese, Japanese, and Korean, the Koreans are that the play the most similar to Western pianists. But I think that there are great cultural differences, and then sometimes it can be a problem.
Days after the first round, 40 contestants representing various countries gathered to compete in the second round. Those who performed a scherzo in the first round must play something of a different genre, like a ballad or a polonaise in the second round. Polish contestants are always in the spotlight of the competition because it's held in Warsaw. One of them, Simon Nering, drew attention as a viable contender early on because of his balanced performance and superb skills. Cynical and witty scherzos, extravagant and artistic ballads. And Polonaise, the national Polish dance transformed into a serious music genre. All these competitions depict Chopin's emotions and thoughts. Therefore, the contestants must transform themselves into the great composer each moment of their performance.
Of course, listening to the music and feeling emotions is not easy. Human development, and through that, through his philosophy or his art, or his composition, to convey a message to the audience, to plant something in the audience, to have a role.
The third round of the competition, the last stage before the finals, is about to begin. Only 10 of the 20 contestants will be chosen to go on to the finals. Cho Sung-jin, Han Chi-ho, and Kim Soo-yeon are among the 20. The core of the third round is mazurkas and scherzos. Mazurkas, which Chopin began to write at the age of 6, were his favorite genre that he continued to compose all his life. Contestant Eric Liu has been calm since day one of the competition. He is the winner of the 2014 Moscow Chopin Youth Piano Competition and the 2013 Minnesota International Piano E Competition. He is regarded as a promising next generation artist in the United States.
This is because each prelude mood changes character. It's completely different, and the amount of. But this music is so incredible. So many unbelievable moments in it, and also you want to just. It's really breathless. Some preludes, and then also some are just so painful and suffering. It's a kind of a whole. Whole thing at once. It's big for audience as well to listen to and to play.
This time, it's the Korean contestant's turn to perform. Han Chi-ho always carries a charming smile, and Kim Soo-yeon says this competition was her childhood dream. Kim Soo-yeon is a promising artist who has won many competitions, such as the Asia Chopin Competition. She has spent the past year playing Chopin's compositions only.
But 또 한 번 연주를 할 수 있는 기회가 주어져서.
Han Chi-ho says he has been enjoying the competition since day one. He's the winner in the piano category of the 2014 Seoul International Music Competition. This year's competition features many Korean contestants. Their skills have improved stunningly over the years, drawing various attention and reviews.
Koreańczycy to jest bardzo zdolny naród. To jest muzycznie o bardzo silna wola twórcza, bym powiedziała. Oni są sprawni bardzo pianistycznie. Oni są bardzo emocjonalni, o dużych temperamentach. Także koreańskich pianistów, w ogóle azjatyckich pianistów, ale pani pyta o koreańskich, słucha się z dużym zainteresowaniem.
From right now in the world, Asian musician or artist already in the world stage will be in the very important also in the place. And a lot of talents come from Asia, from China, Korea or Japan. So that was very good. And Asian, I think, are working very hard and we are serious and we really respect the music and also the great culture. So this is the point. And right now I think it's a great generation for Oriental people who really into the classical music world.
Here's another Korean contender, Cho Sung-jin. From the preliminary round to the two main competition rounds, he never once failed to receive a high score. His performance began with a mazurka, then an entire prelude. He completed his performance with a scherzo, which represented Chopin's passion, dreams, sentimentality, and feelings of love and hatred. His performance was impeccable. Cho Sung-jin received the highest score to advance to the finals. Even the audience cautiously zeroed in on Cho as the most likely winner.
Bardzo dobrze. Kilka osób już było naprawdę wspaniałych. Mnie osobiście najbardziej podobał się Koreańczyk.
Wydaje mi się, że to jest taki doskonały umysł muzyczny, bym powiedziała, i intuicja. Jest właściwie pianistą naszych czasów. Jest to taki nowoczesny, ale Chopin w pewien sposób też jest nowoczesny, bo harmonia Chopina to właściwie jest aktualna po dziś. I ja to widziałam również, tę strukturę harmoniczną w grze właśnie Koreańczyka. Song, tak? Jin Cho.
Song
Jin Cho.
No, muszę powiedzieć, że Cho zagrał bardzo dobrze. Jest szalenie muzykalny, ma piękny dźwięk, znakomitą technikę. Poza tym pięknie kończy frazę, co jest bardzo ważne. Także mnie się on bardzo podobał.
Dziękuję bardzo.
I jestem przekonana, że będzie wśród laureatów.
Autumn in Warsaw is very romantic. Anyone here would be inspired to write a poem, even on a rainy day. Chopin sang through the piano and recited poems through it. On an autumn day that reminded many of his sentimental music, the finals of the competition for choosing the Chopin of the 21st century was held. The Philharmonic Hall is packed with music fans from all over the world.
We just got here a couple of hours ago. It was great. I really enjoyed it, and we're going to stay here until the end. Tonight. So yeah, I really enjoyed it.
Bardzo kochamy jego muzykę i dlatego przychodzimy na konkursy, jeżeli oczywiście mamy miejsca, bo państwo jako grupa to wykupujecie bardzo duże rezerwacje. No.
In the finals, the contestants must perform one of Chopin's piano concertos. That is why harmony with the orchestra is essential. Kate Liu is a Singaporean American. Over the past 9 years, she has won numerous competitions in the US, emerging as a young star. Her performances are gentle and composed, yet they tug on the listener's heartstrings. They convey romantic feelings without using any extravagant techniques. Kate Liu believes that a piano has a soul, and that her performances are the most beautiful when she plays music from the bottom of her heart. Is she satisfied with her final performance?
It was much more satisfying than maybe my third round or something, but that doesn't matter. But I mean, the fact that I was just able to capture so much with this concerto, I'm satisfied. Oh, I've gotten finals. What am I going to do after this? I don't know. I'll see. If I have the urge to go to another competition, maybe I will. But I just want to get to know music really well, you know, keep studying, and that's what I plan to do.
One of the most viable candidates for the grand prize is Charles Richard Hamlin from Canada. He chose a different path from the other 9 contestants. The majority of the contestants picked Piano Concerto No. 1 because it has a larger scale and is more magnificent compared to Piano Concerto No. 2. But Charles Richard Hamlin, a young artist from Canada, was the only one to play Piano Concerto No. 2. There was only one instance of winning the Chopin competition for playing Piano Concerto No. 2. It was Dang Thai Son from Vietnam, who won the 10th competition. Nevertheless, it's welcome news to the orchestra, which has to perform Piano Concerto No. 1 9 times in a row.
Another great gift of Chopin for us, and his melodic genius is set at its best in that movement. So yeah, no, I'm very happy I played it, and I know it has a curse, it seems, at this competition, but I really don't care.
Yeah, Dang Thai Son won.
Yes, but I don't care about winning, you know. I made it clear when I first arrived here, I came from nowhere, you know, no one knew me in Europe, and now look at, you know, there's a bunch of microphones in my face, it's pretty good, you know. So I achieved what I wanted to achieve. I'm very happy.
These contestants have come all the way to the finals. Their relentless passion and determination to do their best have impressed many and excited the classical music sector. The only Korean finalist, Cho Sung-jin, goes on stage.
The first participant of today's session is Song Jin-cho from South Korea.
He performs with a relaxed smile on his face, as if he had performed with this orchestra for a very long time. How will Cho Sung-jin portray Chopin's Piano Concerto No. 1? This 22-year-old pianist from Korea says he wants to play music until the day he dies. Cho Sung-jin was engrossed in every moment of his 40-minute performance, communicating with the piano and whispering the things in his heart to Chopin's soul. He staged a graceful yet dramatic and lyrical performance. Through him, the audience felt as if encountering the young Chopin when he wrote Piano Concerto No. 1 at the age of 20. Cho was one with the music. The 18-day Chopin competition of 2015, which was full of anxiety, has finally come to an end. The finals ended late. It's already 1 a.m. However, the reporters and spectators refuse to leave. Everyone is waiting for the announcement of the final results, with all 10 finalists being present.
the final auditions of the 17th Frédéric Chopin Piano Competition have ended today. The sixth prize goes to
Dmitry Shishkin, Russia.
Fifth prize, Tony Yike Yang. Fourth prize, Eric Liu. Third prize, Kate Liu. And the second prize went to Charles Richard Hamlin. Now, only the first prize winner of the 2015 Chopin competition is left to be announced.
Yes. And the winner of the Chopin competition, first prize and gold medal, goes to
San Jin Cho.
For the first time in the history of the Chopin competition and Korean classical music sector, the winner was a Korean, Cho Sung-jin. The last day of the competition was his. He was unrivaled in terms of technique and emotional aspect. It took him enormous effort to receive this honor today. Cho has lived in Paris for a long time in order to better understand Chopin's life and music.
Chopin 그런 뭐 삶을 안다고 음악에 직접적인 연관이 과연 있을까라고 생각 의구심은 들지만 그래도 그냥 저는 알고 싶어가지고 공부를 많이 했어요. 그 프랑스어로 된 뭐 쇼팽의 제자들이 바라본 시선 뭐 이런 책도 읽어보고 그리고 파리는 그 정말 쇼팽이 살았던 도시고 그리고 무덤도 있고 그 쇼팽을 느낄 수 있는 장소가 되게 많은 것 같아요. 그게 굉장히 도움이 많이 됐던 것 같아요.
Cho Sung-jin first made headlines when he won the International Frédéric Chopin Competition for Young Pianists in 2008. In 2011, at the age of 18, he received global recognition by winning the third prize at the Tchaikovsky Competition. But since the day he first performed on stage at the age of 11, his biggest dream was to compete in the Chopin Competition. His dream has come true here in Warsaw.
Nagrodę główną i złoty medal otrzymuje pan Song Jin Cho z Korei Południowej.
The Polish president personally gives out medals to the winners.
It is a great honor to be a winner of the Chopin competition. And still, I cannot believe this moment. And of course, I'm really excited. And I was, of course, I was nervous when I was playing here, but I was happy because I could play Chopin in Warsaw for a Polish audience. And it was a wonderful experience for me. Thank you very much.
Grzegorz Michalski, pełnomocnik dyrektora Instytutu do Spraw Konkursu Chopinowskiego. Jesteśmy bardzo szczęśliwi i podekscytowani faktem, że po raz pierwszy konkurs chopinowski ma zwycięzcę z Korei Południowej. Fantastyczny pianista, który podczas koncertu laureatów podbił serca chyba wszystkich obecnych na sali. Mam nadzieję, że też tych, którzy oglądali w transmisji telewizyjnej, radiowej, internetowej to wydarzenie. Konkurs był na niezwykle wysokim poziomie. Wielka, nigdy wcześniej nienotowana ilość kandydatów i mnogość talentów. Także dla jury było to bardzo trudne zadanie wyłonić tego najlepszego. Myślę, że cała grupa laureatów będzie robić wspaniałe kariery. I za to właśnie trzymamy palce. Życzymy im wszystkiego najlepszego.
Even after winning the Chopin competition, Cho Sung-jin says that to him, Chopin is still an unresolved task.
소나타를 2년 전부터 치기 시작을 했어요. 소나타 2번. 네, 선우트 이번 재작년 연주 했을 때 바로 끝난 다음에 되게 만족스러운 연주였다고 생각을 했어요. 근데 지금 들어보면 너무 이상하게 들리는 거예요. 또 그때 든 생각이 아, 시간이 해결해주는 문제들이 있구나라고 생각을 했어요. 그래서 앞으로 막 5년 뒤에 제가 친 쇼팽 콩쿠르 동영상을 보면 왜 저렇게 치지? 이런 생각이 들 수도 있을 것 같아요.
He has another dream, which is profound yet simple.
저의 꿈은 뭔가 유명해지거나 이런 게 아니고 그냥 좋은 음악을 연주하는 그런 피아니스트가 되는 건데요. 그래서 사실 조금 무섭긴 해요. 또 큰 욕심일 수도 있지만 그 좋은 콘서트홀이 있는 도시에 1,500명이 날 알면 그걸로 충분하다고 생각을 했어요. 그 이상의 명성도 좀 너무 부담스러울 것 같고 제가 여기까지 올 수 있었던 것도 되게 한국 선생님들, 친구들의 서포트가 있었기 때문에 가능했던 거고 앞으로 이제 유럽에서 조금 더 열심히 해볼 계획이고요.
He doesn't want to be a momentary star. He wants to become an artist who will be loved for a long time. That is why, to him, this Chopin competition is not the end, but the beginning. His new endeavors as a young great master have begun.